Alright, so let's jump right into this thing. Today I'm using Cover FX Natural Finish Oil Free Foundation in the color G70. I love it because they have a wide shade range and they have a very, I would say, sensitive formula, especially for somebody with sensitive skin like me. I'm trying to refine my skin and I'm doing a lot of skincare to sort of like take care of blemishes and pores, so this really helps to sort of keep my skin fresh. Using the 190 MAC foundation brush, I'm just sort of starting at the center of my face and building the coverage where I need it. Usually like in the center of my face where I have a lot of pores and like around my neck area are the places I like to cover the most. So you'll see me doing a lot of different techniques to cover up blemishes there. One of my favorites with the 190 is to sort of like pat the foundation in place. So here, I'm just layering up a little bit more of the foundation. I'm moving to a different room so that I can have the better light. I'm just layering up that 190 with that 190. Now I'm using the Nude Stix Cover Concealer Stick in the shade Deep 8. Underneath my eyes, anywhere I have a lot of cooler pigmentation, especially like around my neck and my beard area. I shaved there a lot. When I was younger, I used to suffer from shave bumps. Now that I have my technique down, I don't get as much anymore, but I still have a little bit of texture there. And especially with the color that that is left over from the scarring, it's really good to use a warmer concealer to just sort of conceal those spots. And then again, I'm using that 190 foundation brush from MAC just to sort of press and melt that foundation and concealer into the skin to get a seamless, poreless finish. You see, I'm clocking the mug, huh? So now I'm using Hourglass's brow pencil in the color Ash. And I love them because they are such a velvet texture. And especially with my brows, they're already thick. I don't like to use a brow pencil that has a whole lot of like warm tones to it. I just need it to add the structure around my brow. So you'll see me outline on the bottom of my brow from the front all the way through to the end. And then for this look, I'm doing more of a bold look. So I'm definitely going to outline the top of my brow as well. Do that to your needs. Everybody has a different style of brow they like. And I'm just using the other end of that, which is a spoolie end, which allows you to blend your brow. Oh, so perfect. That spoolie is like velvet on your skin. It doesn't exfoliate your skin like the Anastasia Beverly Hills one. Anastasia Beverly Hills one is very firm. I'm just going back over that just to make sure things are perfect. Okay, now it looks like we moved on to highlight. So we're going to use that 190 to just place a highlight underneath my eyes. Today I'm using Studio Finish Concealer in NW35 mixed with the Peach Shade that's going to be featured in the MAC Studio Finish Concealer Palette that you can get from MAC Cosmetics. And I'm using a beauty blender just to sort of blend that out on the high points in my face. So first I place the product, now I'm using that tapered end to just sort of blend and melt that right into the skin. I've highlighted the tops of my cheekbones, my nose, and my forehead. I don't really see a need to highlight my chin, I have a goatee. Now going in with the MAC 252 brush, I'm going to start to highlight the tops of my brow bone. And I like to use a softer natural hair brush there because it gives you good placement. The brush is wide and porous, so it places the product perfectly, but it doesn't put too much there. I love how Romero Jennings said, you don't want an ocean of concealer underneath your brow. Ocean of concealer. Subtle shade. Now I'm using that same brush, I just turned it on the other side, and I'm using the MAC NW50 Studio Finish Concealer from the Dark palette, from the Studio Finish Concealer palette, to just sort of contour the darker, more shadowy hollows in my face. Around the forehead, cheekbones, the nose, stay very close to the bone of the nose for your contour. You don't want your nose to seem wider. You want it to seem very thin. And then I'll even do the outside corners of my eyes because I like a very natural shadowing around my eyes. I'll even use some of my under eye discoloration and just leave it out. That helps me get a nice shadow. And I'm just using a smaller beauty blender. Just go around and blend everything in place. You know, a finger never hurt nobody. Dream is never done, so And then I use my larger beauty blender to blend the larger places into place. Going back over my nose just to make sure everything's perfect and blended. Clock the mug. Now going in with a little bit of Ben Nye banana powder on top of that very moist beauty blender. And this is the area of the beauty blender where I haven't used the contour. I'm just sort of layering that up underneath my contour to give it a sharper, more defined look, and underneath my eyes to catch any eyeshadow that I'm gonna put on. And also to do a technique called cooking, where you leave the powder on for like, you know, 10-15 minutes while you work on another feature, and it increases the look of your highlight. It makes it more full coverage, and it really shows up in photographs. I'm just layering more and more of that powder as I see fit. Going in with my MAC 217 blending brush and adding a little bit of banana powder there. And you see I reached into my Kevyn Aucoin palette. And I'm using shade number 5 to fine and warm brow on the 217. And to just go and hollow out my crease just a little bit with that warm shade. And I'm also using them on the inner corner of my eyes and down the side of my nose. I'll continue doing that till I feel like I'm defined enough. And then I'm going to go for the shade number 6, Shade and Dark Brow, in the Kevyn Aucoin Art of Contouring book. And I mix both of them together on my Becca Contouring Kabuki brush. And I go right into the hollows of my face, right in between where we put that highlighter. Remembering to find every place. Use my Makeup Forever fan brush. I'm just dusting off any excess powder that I used to get a blended look. Forget the center of your face. Now I'm going in with the Nude Stix liner. And I love Nude Stix because you get precision and you get conveniency. I mean, you can take those things anywhere. And it's a double-ended one. It's got a matte bronze color, which is what I'm using right now in the inner corner of my eye. And it's got a darker bronze color as well, which is more like a deeper gold, which I'm going to use on my lid and blend out with my finger. Going back to the Nude Stix Concealer in Deep 8, I'm using that as lipstick today. Great for precision. It's great to use your own concealer as your perfect nude. And I'm going to go over the top of that with lip gloss from MAC's Artificially Wild collection from last year. It's a special edition, girl, sorry. It's called De-Nude. Has the perfect bit of olive and gold sparkle in it. And then, of course, layering up some mascara before I put on my lashes. Today I'm using, it looks like Audacious mascara from NARS. I like it because it gives me a really chunky volume. Great for a glamorous look like what we're doing today. Even though we're going nude, we still are, you know, keeping everything very glamorous and soft, well blended, well placed. And then I'm using just a little bit of the shimmer powder from the Kevyn Aucoin palette and accentuate and highlight the shade number 4. Taking my 217 and placing that along the top of my brow, the inner corner of my highlight, right on top of where I put the new. So I stepped away for a bit and I went and popped on a pair of lashes, of course with Duo Lash Adhesive. I use Lash Lovers lashes in the style Starlitez HD for this look. And I went in with the Clinique liner, retractable style, and it's waterproof. And it's just an olive gold shade, olive with gold sparkle. Securing my lashes, blending by pinching my lashes together, and that's the final look, guys. Bronzed and beat.
Get it right.
So So guys, if you like this look, please subscribe to my channel. Support. The more support I get, the more of these I can do for you guys. And let's turn this into a regular thing. Thank you so much for supporting me. And look forward to the next tutorial.